Hello everyone, this here is Ziad. I recently got into this hobby of watch repair and especially mechanical movements. So I really arbitrarily took a decision to create a YouTube playlist, and its name will be Rubies, as reference to the ruby jewels in a mechanical movement. So let's get ahead with this video. As I'm really a beginner, I thought of using relatively cheap practice watches to actually disassemble and reassemble. This watch uses a generic Swiss movement. It's manual winded. So let's go ahead and open this. It has Swiss 17 jewels engraved on it. So the first thing that you need to actually do is to remove the crown and the stem. So now if you have the crown outside, you can simply just remove the movement and the dial from the watch. So as you can see here, the dial is really beautiful. I really like it. And it also has some loom. I can attach a night shot of this watch. So this bracket doesn't allow the movement to actually move around freely inside the case. And you can actually push on the movement to get it out. Really simple. Now the next thing that we need to do is to reattach the crown. Gently just press on this button here to actually re-enable the stem to move backwards into the movement. Just like that. What I did was that I removed the dial from the watch. And I explained the problem with this watch, which was that they doesn't regularly shift from one to the other. And it probably needs some oiling, because running these handles are really difficult and feels really grippy. So as you see, the date doesn't shift. So the first thing that you want to do when disassembling any watch movement is that you remove the balance wheel. You'll be able to remove this bracket with the wheel. I'll get this tiny container and fill it up with gas that actually cleans them. So I got here some of this liquid. Start to directly place the movement on it. Now, the next thing that we want to remove is the pallet fork. You can very simply remove this bracket, and you can remove the pallet fork. So this tiny piece is what actually regulates the escapement of the motion. We need to remove this bracket. Now this here is a relatively old movement, so you don't expect to see some proprietary screws or anything like that. It's really simple. Now, as you see here, you have 1, 2, and the third one is the escapement gear. These are the gear train of the movement. There is no movement without these three gears, I guess. And the next thing that you need to do is you have to actually remove this gear here. Now this gear is the main winding gear. This is actually what winds up and loads the spring of the main barrel. So to do this, just unscrew the screw and remove this gear. Now under it, you'll see a very tiny spring. This is what ticks when you wind the watch. Now you can remove the first gear of the gear train. And after you remove this plate, we can remove the second gear. Now all I'm doing here is just disassembling the movement to actually clean it up. So it doesn't solve the main problem, which is the calendar issue. And honestly, I don't know how to resolve this. So this is the winding bracket. Now, once you remove this winding bracket, you'll see the spring barrel. This is the main power reserve element in any movement. Now you can see the second gear of the gear train, and you'll see the escapement gear, which is this tiny, very distinctly shaped, tiny little gear. So the next step is to remove this bracket here. We have the other side of the movement still, which contains the complications. Now this is the first time for me to actually disassemble a movement similar to this. So I'll assume that I have to remove this bracket over here. I don't really know how these function. So this here is the spring for the calendar. This is the calendar ring. And here you have the yoke. This here is the yoke spring. It actually shifts when you move from one to another position. So there is a really tiny gear that settles down here and connects to this one and connects to this one. So let's move, disassemble this gear train. I have another gear. And on the other side, we have a small gear system that seems to be locked down with a screw. So we have now removed the upper gear train. So we have here the main yoke spring. We have a secondary lever. This is what actually holds the crown in place. And we have a secondary yoke that doesn't seem to actually want to move. Yeah, here it is. And then we have the two gears of the crown. We have here the two gears of the crown. And the crown. So I just noticed that the gear here is a bit bent. So I will try to put it back together. It's a bit better in shape now. An empty chassis. And we have got all the components over here. These are the components, clean of any dirt and grease, and we are going to re-oil and reassemble the entire movement. Get the crown and place it in here. The stem enters just like that. Now be careful, because this gear actually differs from one direction to the other. Just like that. Now we have got two levers. And this one goes right there. And that stays here. So it needs the yoke spring to stay in place. Here. This is the yoke spring. Goes here. We need to place everything in place. As you see, the yoke has gotten out of its position. The crown now clicks perfectly. I'm not using expensive oils because I'm a beginner still. So I'm using this generic Swiss made Wolch oil. I want to place a little bit of oil. So there was this gear. It goes here. And then the smaller symmetrical gear that goes right there. We move on to the secondary gears. I believe this is what turns the ring of the calendar. Okay. There is something wrong with the calendar, as I mentioned. Try to figure out what it actually is. Let's get this set in place. Now this tiny little thing here is what actually shifts the day. So let's see. It should start shifting from here. Okay. Now this here is the problem. This gear has a spring that is not in a good shape. This tiny knob should push against this to make it shift its position. Right now it's not working good enough. It's sliding above the... Okay. This should be a pretty easy fix, I guess. Of course, the best way is to replace this spring. I'll try to manually shape it. So I'm back after readjusting the spring of this gear. This is what actually caused the problem. It was warped upward, so it didn't hit this. These nicks. Supposedly this will work now just fine, so we'll have to reassemble it. And it's tight on the plate here. So supposedly now it should work just fine. Place back the spring. And place back the date plate. And now catches on this ring over here perfectly, and it shifts without any friction. So the upper part now is totally working perfectly. What I'll do now is I'll oil it up and we're good to go to the back side. Now, the easy part. Hopefully we have figured out the calendar issue. Now the first thing that we'll need to do is, from this part, is to place this back bracket to place on this. Replace the spring barrel. This is the second gear of the gear train. It's placed over it, just like that. This is the escapement gear, and the final one. So now the gear train is fully placed, as you see here. Now this bracket is what holds everything together. The bracket is well seated. Now we'll place the tiny spring. So this is now placed well fitted. Now if you wind the watch without the pallet fork, it will go endlessly. The pallet fork is what prevents the spring from unwinding endlessly. It gives it an end. This is the pallet fork. After we replace this bracket, we'll be able to wind the watch without it losing any power. So what we'll do now is that we will wind up the watch just to be able to see when the balance wheel is correctly engaged. This is the balance wheel. When we place it back, it will start ticking. So let's see. There we go. It's ticking perfectly. Now the final thing that I want to do is I want to make sure that the arms are correctly aligned with the date. So I'll have to empty the barrel once again and leave it go. And it stopped. We'll place the final gear, which is the hours. We'll have to place back the dial right now. The dial is really nice. And we will place it right as it belongs. There we go. It's ticking. Let's check for the date. As you see now, it started shifting, and then at here we go. So it's almost perfect, and now it is time to place it into the case. Safely remove the crown to replace it into its case. We can put back the case. So this project is done. Of course, after the oiling, it's so much more easy to wind. If you guys have any corrections for things that I said incorrectly, please let me know. And thank you for watching.